Scottish play, Owen set her sights on sharing the crown with her husband, Thane Macbeth. Macbeth conspired to a plan to murder the King of Scotland, Duncan. I've really forgotten this.
That's okay. That's okay.
In Act 1, Scene 7, however, Macbeth, Miss Leadham, I'd memorized this before, and now I'm like, okay, Macbeth, I'll just say it my own way.
Good, do it.
In the first scene I'm going to do...
But she got three ones at stake, just so y'all know.
I don't remember the intro.
Tell about your character and the scene you're going to
She's
do.
Crazy.
She's awesome.
So basically, she wants to be queen, and Macbeth is kind of a wuss, so she's like, I want to be a man. And then he comes in and she's like, haha, just kidding. And then later on, like, there's going to be some scene skipping. So later on in the play, Kate was trying to help me remember this. And
he goes back.
That is perfect. Jesus is fine.
And then in the next scene, I'm trying to convince him to go through with our plan to murder Duncan because he's becoming a little wuss. And not
good.
So.
Yeah. She's mad. She's angry.
The raven himself is hoarse that croaks the fatal entrance of Duncan under my battlements. Come, you spirits that tend on mortal thoughts. Unsex me here and fill me from the crown to the toe top full of direst cruelty. Make thick my blood. Stop the access and the passage to remorse, that no compunctious visitings of nature shake my fell purpose, nor keep peace between the effect and the effect. Come, thick night, and pall thee in the dunnest smoke of hell, that my keen knife see not the wound it makes, nor heaven peep through the blanket of the dark to cry, ho, ho. Great Gladys, worthy Cawdor, Duncan comes here tonight and goes hence tomorrow. Oh, never shall sun that tomorrow see. Your face, my thing, is as a book where men may read strange matters. To beguile the time and look like the time, bear welcome in your eye, your hand, your tongue. Looks like the innocent flower. But be the serpent underneath it. He that is coming must be provided for. And you shall put tonight's great business into my dispatch. Leave all the rest to me. My Thane! Was the hope drunk wherein you dressed yourself? Had this slept since, awakes now to look so green and pale, but it did so freely. From this time, such I account thy love. Art thou feared to be the same in thine own act and valor as thou art in desire? Wouldst thou have that thou esteem'st the ornament of life, and live a coward in thine own esteem? That if I dare not wait upon, I would the poor cat in the adage. What beast was then that you break this enterprise to me? When you durst, then you were a man. To be more than what you were, you would be so much more of a man. Nor time nor place did in it here. And yet you would make them both. They have made themselves, and their fitness now does unmake you. I have given suck, and know how tender 'tis to love the babe that milks me. I would, my face, had plucked my nipple from its boneless gums, and dashed the brains out, had I so